That's really good stuff.
Huh?
Hey YouTube, what's up? This is Ben from the Be a Photographer channel. And in this video, we're going to be talking about how you can clean spots up in your image in post-production, because sometimes you just forget or can't before the actual shoot. When you first look at these three images, you shouldn't see anything wrong with them. And that's perfect. But I'll have you know, I actually used the clone and heal tools in order to remove Megan's nose stud. So that disappeared pretty quickly. Fill in the gap between birds on this image in the bottom, and also remove the palm tree reflection and some front bumper damage from my car in the shot up top. So let me show you how to do this. Let's get started with this image of Megan. Let's say we had a client who loves this photo but doesn't want the nose stud in there, so we can remove that really easily. I'm going to zoom in and then hold down on the plus icon where we create our layers and select new heel layer. Once I have that, I'm going to rename this to nose stud to stay organized in case I need a bunch of layers on the file, and then hit B for brush. You can change your brush by right clicking and then sliding to the right for a larger brush or left for a smaller brush, or using the keyboard bracket keys right next to the P key. So left makes it smaller and the right bracket key makes it larger. So now I have a brush set. I'm going to click down and brush in this area, and you'll see it creates this line with an arrow and a second circle. This second circle is called your source point, and automatically Capture One will select what it thinks is the best source point. So to move this source point, you can either drag that point to wherever you want from the image, or you can hold the Alt button on your keyboard and then select anywhere on your image you want to use as the source point. Here's some tips for source points. Make sure it is selecting something with similar lighting, similar depth of field slash focus, and skin tones. So in this case, just make sure you're not selecting from the eyes, you're not selecting from the lips, and you're not selecting from the middle of the nose where it's super bright. Just select right next to where the nose stud is, and you'll see when we let go after about half a second, it loads and perfectly heals that area. So here it is with the layer off, here it is with the layer on, looks good. Let me walk you through what the clone tool does versus heal. If we switch this to clone, you can see now it has a little bit of a circular outline. Clone literally just clones the pixels that you select. Think of it as copy paste. If we change the source point to the middle of the nose here, you'll see it copies these bright pixels and pastes them right over the nose stud. If we were to use the heal option, you'll see it changes the brightness and luminosity a little bit. So think of heal as clone plus auto adjustment for tone matching. And that way we want to select a source point that's close, but doesn't have to be perfect. If you ever need to have that grab tool again, and for whatever reason you're not getting it, just press the B key for brush and you'll have the line with the source point show up. Let's move on to this image with the birds. If I reset it, you'll see that there was a gap between some of the birds, and I want to add extra birds. So I'm going to hold plus, and I can select clone here because the sky is all the same. I'll call this extra bird. I'm going to brush in an area and then select my source point. You want to make sure the area you brush is big enough to fit your entire clone. If I only made a circle that was about that big, it's not going to fit this entire bird. You'll see if I let go of the source point here, it's just going to copy that much. So to fix this, we just need to brush some more here, and you'll see that it's literally brushing in. Now, if we zoom in closely, you'll notice that it has this halo around it because the lighting is just a tiny bit different. So I'm just going to change it to heal, and you can see it changed the luminosity to add it perfectly. And if I wanted to change where this mask is, I can simply grab it by using the brush tool and move the bird wherever I want. There we go. The bird is here. Or the bird is there. Or if I want to change my source point, I can hold option and select this bird here. Drag it up a little bit so it doesn't catch the bottom feathers of this bird. And now I have cloned birds. And we could do this as many times as we want. One thing to note is that you can only clone from the background layer. So you can see I added all these extra birds, but if I moved my source point over one of these, it's not going to change. See, doesn't work. But this was an original bird from the background file, and now I can add that. Okay, so that's going over the top, but it shows you there's a lot you can do with this tool. Let's go to one final image where I'll show you how to select multiple points using just one source point. If we reset this file, you can see there's a little bit of a palm tree reflection in the hood of the car. I'm going to get rid of that. It's gone. If I want to leave the reflection but have it be a little bit more subtle, I can simply lower the opacity of my heel layer, and that way I can control how strong slash how dark that reflection is in the car. So it's slightly there, it's totally there, and it's gone. Okay, let's take a look at the bumper here where I have some rock chips, and I want to fix this but not spend time setting a source point for each one of these little dots. So I'm just going to create a heel layer, call this front bumper fixes, and select my source point before even starting. Just hit option, select a point that's kind of neutral, so right there. And now when I brush, I can brush over multiple areas. So I'm gonna brush here, I'm gonna brush right there, and I'm gonna brush here. And you can see that all these different spots, although they're in different areas of the hood, are getting fixed with the heel layer all on just one layer. So if I were to turn the layer off, there's our rock chips, and if I turn the layer back on, they're magically gone.
Thanks for watching. I hope you learned something. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, leave a comment, and I'll see you in the next video that comes out in 2 days. Peace.